Hi, I will present a technique called dependency scheduling to speed up container launch time. This is a joint work with Radhika Mittal from UIUC, Lei Zhang from Alibaba Group, and Sylvia Ratnasamy from UC Berkeley. Containers have been adopted in many companies. People have created and shared millions of container images, with the majority of containers deployed on a container orchestrator, Kubernetes. There are emerging applications and frameworks in edge computing that fall in the container space. However, containers suffer from slow start problem. In order to start a container, one needs to first fetch the container image from a remote storage, where the image includes dependencies such as binaries and configuration files. Once fetched, the container image also needs to be decompressed and to be set up on the file system. This operation can all consume network or compute resources and can take a non-trivial amount of time to complete. Say if the compute task at the edge have a short running time, then the startup time and overhead can be too much for the overall efficiency, for example, in the case of serverless functions. Let's take a closer look. As a simplifying example, to launch a container, one submits its configuration file to the cluster's master node, which picks a node to run the container. Then the node agent fetches or pulls the container image from a remote repository. And finally, it starts the container. We micro benchmark each of these steps in order to understand how much time it takes for each of these steps to complete. For the image or dependency pooling, we profile with more than 50,000 container images hosted on a cloud repository and pull images from a cloud instance with Docker container runtime. The results show that the average image pulling latency is about 20 seconds, where, as we briefly mentioned, an image includes all the container's dependencies, including its binaries, libraries, and configuration files, and so on. We believe the compute and network resources can be more limited for the edge setup, and the dependency pooling latency can only be worse. We also add instrumentation to get the scheduling time on Kubernetes and container boot time on Docker to obtain the numbers for the other two steps. These numbers, as they do not involve network transfer and file decompression, should be less affected as in an edge cluster setup. As we measure the time it takes for each of the three steps, we see that the image pulling latency is the dominant contributor to startup latency. So here's the simple question we want to answer. Can we speed up the container startup without changing too much of the underlying compute infrastructure so that any techniques we use can be easily deployed? So given that image pulling takes most of the time, a natural question is, can we avoid pulling image? This leads to the first design of dependency scheduling, that the master node tracks which node or machine has the image installed already and prefers scheduling the container request to that node. Doing so will save the node from pulling the image. This approach is simple but has limitations. For example, image names can change, and such changes will lead to misses in image match. Also, image match makes a binary decision. Either finds a node that has the image and also has available resources, or none. Can we improve image matching? If we look into the container image, each image consists of layers. Each layer is essentially a set of dependencies developers group together. Each layer has a hash digest generated from the layer's content. We found from our chase that layer sharing is common across images because of the reuse of popular dependencies, and that an image typically has many versions which shares common layers. Given these findings, we argue that the container image layer should be treated as the unit of dependency, and the master node should perform dependency matching over layers. This leads to our second design. That is, instead of making the master node aware of image locality, Let's make it aware of layer locality. When a container request is submitted, we identify what are the layers inside the image, and match the layers on the nodes, where we pick the node that has the largest total size of matched layers, and then schedule a container to that node. This provides a content addressable and fine-grained matching for dependency locality. Before we go to the result, let's do the reality check. Is this easy to be deployed on today's edge infrastructure? This is an overview of today's Kubernetes container orchestrator. The master node comprises an API server and a scheduler. The worker nodes contain the node agent kubelet, the container runtime, and an external image repository. To support image match, one only needs to enable image info tracking on API server and the image match scheduling logic in the scheduler. And then for layer matching, one needs to add a layer tracking module on the node agent and the API server, the scheduling logic, and the image resolution module to identify layers in the requested image. These changes involve only a few hundred lines of code in total. Cool. Let's take a look at the results. We set up a Kubernetes cluster and generate synthetic container requests. We compare the image match and layer match scheduling policies against the baseline dependency agnostic policy. For startup latency, we found that image match and layer match reduces the average startup latency by 1.4x and 2.3x, respectively. Besides, image match and layer match improve resource efficiency by saving the amount of disk space to store container images, as well as the CPU cycles to decompress those images. We want to highlight a few open problems, despite the promising performance improvements. First, whether and how is the startup latency of real-world edge system and workloads, as well as the task running time look like? In a broader sense, we need some ways to categorize edge workloads in terms of the startup time. Likewise, we need ways to categorize container image and layer size distribution and their popularity distribution with respect to the node cache size. For example, say if the total size of popular layer is less than the layer cache size of a single node, then one may simply cache all the popular layers in every node, such that dependency scheduling and any other agnostic policies would perform similarly, because the policy randomly picks a node, the node would have all the popular layers anyway. But on the other hand, if the total size of a popular layer exceeds the cache size of a single node, but is less than or close to the total layer cache size of all the edge nodes combined, then the dependency scheduling will win in such a case, because although the popular layers cannot be cached on every node, they can be cached on some of the nodes in the edge cluster. So dependency scheduling is able to identify these nodes and pick this node to schedule the container, and which will improve the startup time. Next, what are the implications of the performance improvement? For example, can we do more aggressive auto-scaling at the edge given the lowered startup overhead? Can we run application at a larger scale? How much savings on the cost and power consumption we can achieve, and so on? Finally, are there any other forms of data locality issues and solutions for containers at the edge that need to be addressed? There are other system-wide open issues that this paper does not explore. For example, how does dependency scheduling interacts with other scheduling policies, such as bin packing and load balancing? This is because dependency scheduling can lead to overutilization of nodes who have a large set of popular dependency, such that the scheduler with dependency scheduling policy may always prefer these nodes. Besides, how much overhead does dependency scheduling can introduce to Kubernetes systems, such as the API server and such as the node to master communication? We hope to hear and learn more issues from the audience of this workshop. More generally, we expect debates, arguments, and ideas surrounding the container and Kubernetes technologies that are emerging at the edge. We look forward to discussion on what compute abstraction and frameworks that are best suited for edge workloads. As a summary, containers and container images are the emerging tools to facilitate software reuse in deployment, including the edge. Such reuse can lead to substantial dependency sharing between containers, and dependency-aware scheduling can use such sharing, and it is highly effective, as we show, to cut container startup latency. With that, I conclude the talk. Thank you.